So everything on here is 3D printed?
Everything is black except for the wheels.
So 120 miles?
He's had it up to 130 so far. It'll go faster.
Oh no, I meant for charge.
He says it'll go about 120 miles on charge with the batteries that he's got. And then supposedly the new ones coming from Tesla will double that.
So. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, Tesla batteries? Nice.
He had an interesting experience. He was a racer himself, the guy that built this. And he didn't like the way the power was being delivered to the motor. So he developed his own chip to respond properly. As he was developing it, he was out on the track and he hit 90 miles an hour and the bike took off and did a wheelie on him and left him on the ground. And then he found an error in the code. So when he hit 90, it just dumped all the power into the motor and left it on the ground at 90 miles an hour.
It's not a pleasant experience.
So how long do you think it took to print this?
Total print job wasn't all that long. It took him about 2 years to develop it because he did all the design and testing and all that stuff. I think the printing itself is just
kind of... The guy earlier was saying that there's aluminum plates and the down tubes in the front end. It's like a multi-print part.
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple of these things that have tubes in them, but most of it's not. It's the carbon fiber nylon is used for all the structures. That's why it's so light.
How light is it?
Only weighs 220 pounds.
It's not bad.
Two of us good.
My Vulcan was like 600-700 pounds.
Yeah. What kind of plastic did you say it's printed?
All carbon fiber.
Nice.
So the structural components.
Yeah.
He's got some carbon fiber PETG in there, and then some of the decorative stuff, like the thing that looks like a gas tank and isn't, is carbon fiber ABS.
I assume there were electronics in there.
Yeah.
Or is it just there to look cool?
That's where the plug is.
Good plan.
He's got
no gears or anything, huh?
No, it's...
You got front and rear brake on the handlebars?
It's a variable drive. There's no shift.
All you do is hit go.
You just hit go. Yep.
With ABS brakes and everything? Disc brakes.
So is this the only one like it, or y'all have more motorcycles?
So far, he's got round two going on now, and he's talking about producing 200 of them 6 or 8 months from now.
Is he just going to produce them and run a line of them, or is he going to do it open source?
I haven't asked him that question. I don't know the answer. He's also developing a trail bike.
Now that would be interesting. Yeah. I already got a project bike going, but I've said for a while for my next bike I wanted a dual purpose. But this might, if I can print out my own bike.
He was a racer, so he wanted to, his first one was a racer.
It's pretty neat.
You're one of those guys that drops his knee going around a corner at, 100 miles an hour. Oh yeah, that's right.
I'd be worried that thing would be too light to even hold you to the ground, man.
Yeah, you definitely want carbon fiber to be in there.
He's been trucking on it already. He's laid it down a couple of times.
This one?
Yeah, I had to reprint some of the parts.
That's my next question. But I mean, at least it held up for the most part through that, I guess, huh?
He hasn't had any structural issues.
That's good.
When he laid it down, you get like the carbon fiber ABS was damaged.
That's pretty neat. I already got y'all's car, but I'm gonna get one of these for me.
Yeah. Scott's